Problems a bit with illness. Markus Thiepemann, before and during the game, he felt pretty sick. You couldn't realize so much on the pitch, but yeah, he was really totally exhausted after the game and were a bit concerned if everything worked. But yeah, he seems to be okay and was able to train today, and so no doubt for tomorrow. Yeah, also Louis Thompson felt again a bit in his hamstring, but all sorted, so he can travel with us. So quite normal, a few hits or whatever. So Todd had a swollen eye, got a hit with an elbow. Yeah, but all okay so far. A bit headache directly after the game, but all okay. Yeah, otherwise in terms of injuries, some good news was on Hernandez. He was able the first time to be together with us on the training pitch, so his first team training today. And okay, it's a bit too early to have him together with us for the derby game, but he could be probably an option for Stoke for the next home game. So some good news. Yeah, sadly no progress at the moment with Kenny McLean. Yeah, that's pretty concerning. So our doctors and medical department is yeah, working pretty hard and tries everything, but yeah, he still feels some pain in his movements, and yeah, no progress at this moment. That's a bit annoying. So some good news with Sonel. Still a bit concerned with Kenny, but it's like it is, and yeah, we have to handle it.
We haven't asked you about it for a few weeks. Where are we with Grant Hanley? What sort of progress is he making? What timeline are you looking at with him?
Yeah, and this during this week he got his last injection, and we will also rescan him on Thursday to have a last check, and if everything is okay and it seems to be okay, then we can yeah, start the last step in his rehab, and then hopefully he can yeah, anyone during the international break return to the team training. If everything works, would be the perfect plan. So to have him then perhaps in 2 weeks back in team training would be nice, and yeah, at least that's a hope and that's a plan, and at the moment it looks pretty good, and I hope we are able to do like this.
Forgive me, Daniel. What exactly was it he did at that time? You said it was something to come away from the ligament.
Yeah, it was a bit special, a structural damage in his quad. So it was more like, it's called, I think the right expression is regloving. So it's more like the muscle fibers have the tendency to yeah, lose the connection, and anyhow with these injections they should have been animated to grow back. So in order to sort the structural damage out, and it seems to be okay, but we have to rescan it during this week, and then if everything works, he can yeah, start to build up his strength in this quad, and then hopefully everything is okay.
Ben Marshall played for the development squad on Friday. Is he with you tomorrow?
Yeah, we make a late decision if he's in the squad. So at least we've got some good options. Yeah, at least he's available, and we'll have a late decision if he's in our traveling squad. Yeah, to be honest, at the moment there are not so many reasons to change the squad, because yeah, we're pretty successful. All the lads are doing pretty well. So although we still have some important players injured, so there's still a lot of competition, and with Ben we'll make a late decision.
Yeah, as you say, the result will tell you there's not a lot of reason to change the squad. But in terms of your 11, I think the last three league games you've gone with the same 11. Are you just feeling with the nature of the workload really as much as anything, it might be a time maybe just to have a look at freshening up a little bit in the 11?
Yeah, so it's always a question when you have lots of load. Yeah, if you rotate a bit to bring some recreated players on the pitch, or on the other to stick together with the players who were pretty much involved before, in order not to break the rhythm too much. And yeah, to be honest, so in the first week of this spell, I got the feeling, so don't rotate too early, because it's more like, okay, after the international break, then you can have 3 games in a row. Meanwhile, it's the third week where we have to do this, so for that we have to be careful. But also in this terms, I will make a late decision, because in general, so the break from Saturday afternoon till Wednesday evening is not too bad, so it's okay. Normally, it's enough time to recreate. It's perhaps even a bit more for the Stoke game then, because we will arrive, yeah, early Thursday morning just back, and have the next game then on Saturday. So the time between the Derby and the Stoke game is shorter. I think it's perhaps a bit more to rotate there, but I'm also tempted because we had some, really good. We have some really good opportunities to bring some recreated players in. So yeah, for example, Mario Frontage was crucial in the last games when he came in. Also, Tom Tribal, I think it's one of the toughest calls at the moment. Okay, he's always in the squad and was involved sometimes in the for 10 or 15 minutes, but not to playing him starting lineup at the moment is it's unbelievably tough because he's training really on an outstanding level, and when you watch his training session, so it's more like you would say, okay, he plays in the starting level for Barcelona. But we also got Alex Setia in the moment, and Alex. It's also when you judge his games, also outstanding. And meanwhile, he seems to be also a pretty big threat in the box of the opponent, close to the box of the opponent. So in the last games, I think he was there with not in the last game there. Marcus Thiebermann was there with many, many strikes, but in the games before with many shooting positions. And he looks a bit at the moment like could I compare him with Claude Makélélé or something like this? Just even a bit better. So it's really tough. It's really tough at the moment. But I'm tempted to have some changes.
Yeah, and you mentioned quite a few.